tutorial video, we're going to be doing another fabric brooch or hair accessory, depending on what you want to use it for. You can even use it for a bag accessory, use it as a hand throw accessory, whatever you want to use it for, you can. So in this project, you're going to cut 4 by 4 inches fabric. Okay, before we get straight into the materials you'll be needing for this project, I would like to introduce Skill Dance organization to you if you don't know about it already. So this organization is a small charity based in Nottingham, United Kingdom, that empowers women through artisan craft workshops. So we do millinery, that is hat making, we do dressmaking, jewelry making with beads, we do bag making, and then soap making. So 5 programs are what we do. We have our short programs and our long programs. So our short programs last for 8 weeks and the long programs for 24 weeks. In these workshops, for the 8 programs, you'll be finishing with 8 pieces of project, depending on what you're doing. So if you're doing millinery, you have to finish the whole project with 8 pieces of millinery project. And if it's bag making, you'll be doing 8 pieces of bag making project. If it is tailoring or dressmaking, you would also come out of that project at the end of the 24 weeks with a full garment made, either for a child or for yourself. Okay. And with the jewelry making, you'll be doing 24 pieces of jewelry based on whatever you're doing, but you'll be taking from the basic to the advanced. Just before the whole thing is finished. This program is for unemployed women, stay-home moms, and women on low income living in Nottingham, UK. So let's go on with today's project. Like I said, you'll be cutting 4 by 4 of your fabric, and I have gone ahead to cut my fabric. I have done 24 pieces, so you can do between 20 and 24 pieces, and it's entirely up to you, depending on the density of the brooch you're looking for, the piece you're looking for, and you get to understand in a minute. But when you've done all your cutting, you do your first fold, okay, and then your second fold. All right, I've gone ahead to do my first cut, so I'm going to use this as my guide and then place it on this here, and then I'm going to cut around the shape. Whilst we are at it with the cutting, let me talk to you about another channel of ours. So this channel is called Podcast with Sheila. This channel has the audio version and the video version. The audio version is aired on Apple Podcast, on Google Podcast, on Spotify, on Breaker, Overcast, Pocket Cast, Radio Public. It's on a number of audio platforms. You can find it there. So far as you hit on the link, wherever you are, on whatever listening platform you have, you'll be able to listen to Podcast with Sheila on there. Another platform you can listen to us is on YouTube. So you can find Podcast with Sheila on YouTube. And on Podcast with Sheila, what we do is every week we host a special guest. So these guests are people who have done something remarkable in their life or have a special or a very inspiring life experience or life story they would like to share with us. Okay, I believe that life is a classroom, and we learn daily as we live. Every experience in life teaches us something new we never knew before, and as we allow ourselves to go through that experience, we come out better people, and then we are able to face the world with a kind of strength that we never knew existed. And we only get to identify these strengths after we've gone through those experiences. Okay, so we get people come on board to share with us. Recently, we did one story of this lady who lives in the United States, who has come out with a product, and I was particularly interested in this interview, and I was so excited to do the interview because, one, she's a woman, and two, she's an inventor. Okay, so she's come up with a product called CPR Wrap that helps non-medical respondents to be able to help rescue somebody who is going through a cardiac arrest, or, you know, somebody who is not breathing for some one reason or the other and needs CPR. When you don't have training in that area, if you have this product, which is called the CPR Wrap, you will be able to help anybody who is struggling for breath. Okay, so we have stories like that we've had in the past. People who have come on to share with us, millionaires who have come on to share with us their story, how they were able to make it from nothing, lost it all, and be able to pick it up. So restart again. You know, there are stories like that. Sometimes we go through life and then we make a lot of wealth, but for some reason we lose it all. Some of us, we are not able to pick ourselves up and carry on. Others are able to pick themselves up and carry on and even do better than they were before. And sometimes I believe that when we listen to stories of people like this, we are able to learn a thing or two from it, and then it helps us as we live our lives. So basically, that is what Podcast with Sheila is about. I have interviewed children as well. I think the youngest child I interviewed was around 10 years, if I'm right. Children who are doing remarkable things wherever they find themselves. And some of these children have come from the United States, from Canada, from India, from Ghana, even from England. I have done children like that. So we have a children's channel, which is Time with Ye Ye, and that is only on YouTube, but it's still aired on Podcast with Sheila. So that is what it's about. You can check it out and see if it's something you'd like. I believe you'll definitely like it, because their stories are so inspiring. We've done stories on marital abuse, relationship abuse, you know, child abandonment, how children were abandoned and how they were able to come out of the situation now, better parents, and they have stories to share on stuff like that. These are very interesting stories. When you've checked them out, if you like them, please subscribe and hit on the notification bell so that you'll be notified anytime a new story is being aired. Okay, so I have all my folding done, ready to be fixed. The next step is to stitch this bit here. All right, you're just going to be doing a few tuck stitches in here to hold this bit here down, okay? Cut my base, and I used interfacing for the base. You cut it as big as you can, get some hot glue gun onto it, and after you finish stitching the little ends here, you stick them together. Okay, what you should note is try and line them up beautifully, okay, so that they look rounded in that manner. Okay, so the next step, you're going to be placing the next one in between these two spaces, is going to lay over like that. All right, that is how you're going to carry on till we finish the whole bit. So I'm going to go ahead and finish the little end stitch here for all of them, and then we come and continue with the arrangement. Okay, so we're going on to the next arrangement. We're going to put it in here. Try and make sure that they're lining up at the edge beautifully. So when you've done that, we get in some more glue. So we're just interlaying them in places where the initial ones have joined. I'm going to carry on off camera. So you're just going to try and lay them, you know, in the places where the last two met. Now I'll point something out to you in a minute. The reason why you have to make sure your circles the same shape. Now you see what's happening here, it's not lining up beautifully, so in the end I may have to shape them all up so that they form a beautiful shape. Okay, I'm going to go ahead with it and then I'll come back, then we take it from there. So I'm going to keep building on my layers till they are all full. All right, so at this point we have 20 of them in here. I don't seem to have the density that I want. So I'm going to keep adding on until we get to the number, and I can talk to you about the number. The reason this is happening is the density of the fabric is quite sheer. So it looks like to build up this project in density, you have to keep cutting on. So now what we have now currently is 24, and it doesn't seem to be what I want, because it needs to build up to the top, you know, and I still don't have it. So I'm going to keep adding on till I get what I really want, and then I'll bring it back for you to see. All right, so this is it here. just take a push pearl in the center, and that is it. The beauty of a thing is arrangement of fabrics in layers on the side, as you can see it. Okay, so that is it. You can check out this one in our other video. We've come to the end of today's project. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to like our videos and share them as well. And also don't forget to subscribe. Watch out for the next video of another version of this brooch. Until we meet again.